You know, hi, the, sorry, the great sage Confucius said that in order to get anywhere, no matter how great the distance, no matter how far off the goal, you simply put one foot in front of the other. I'm Kevin Klein, and I'm here to tell you, Confucius rules. Now, you people here watching this video, and I thank you for doing so, you're here for one of two reasons. Somebody twisted your arm, like, for instance, your boss, and you really didn't have any choice in the matter. Alternatively, there could be someone in your life, someone you care about, a sibling, a spouse, a coworker, a parent, a child,
who is living with diabetes,
and you'd frankly like to do something about it. Either way, you can relax. It's not going to hurt.
The JDRF Walk to Cure Diabetes is actually a lot of fun.
I'm the national chairman of this thing, and I've been on I don't know how many walks. I'm here to tell you, it's fun. I mean, you walk, people walk with you, you're outside, it's beautiful. Even if it's not, it's beautiful because you're not alone, you're all together, you're doing this communal thing. You're getting exercise, your heart's beating. And it's healthy for you, and it's really healthy for all those people suffering with diabetes, because each step you take on this walk is bringing us that much closer to a cure. Juvenile or type 1 diabetes carries the risk of serious complications, threatening the kidneys, the eyes, the heart, and it won't ever go away until there's a cure. And the Juvenile Diabetes Research Foundation is funding the research that will cure it. The great thing to remember is that you're already participating in the cure. You and hundreds of thousands of others in over 200 locations in the US, Canada, Italy, Australia, Israel, the United Kingdom, France, Russia, Sweden, and Germany, all of you curing diabetes one step at a time. You walkers will raise an estimated $80 million, and that is going to buy a lot of research. Over 80% of every dollar that comes in goes directly to diabetes research and research-related education. That means that each individual in the walk, each family team, school team, corporate team, has a huge impact in the overall search for a cure. I'd like you to meet a friend of mine. Her name is Holland. She and her mom and dad started a family team called Holland's Hope, and that's just what it is.
The Walk to Cure Diabetes is the one day that we are excited about Holland having diabetes. It is the one day where we are inspired, buoyed by the support of friends and family, and that there are so many people out there with a common goal in mind.
You corporate teams are a big part of this day. Read my lips. You're
playing a major role in curing the disease. So often it starts with just a few people joining in the walk in order to help a coworker who's living with diabetes. And before you know it, you've got new recruits recruiting new recruits, and suddenly there's this exponential growth. Additionally, you get to see your CEO wearing a baggy old sweatsuit. What could be better? It's a win-win situation. Let's go! Those of you students and parents who have joined the school teams are part of an important, fast-growing group. And it's totally great that you realize you're not alone, that you've got thousands and thousands right there with you, rooting for you, working for you, walking to cure you. Let's go! Take two. Ah! Take 20 tie. Two. Take 4,000. Nobody is alone in this. Nobody is alone in this fight. As a matter of fact, you're in great company. Year after year, national sponsors
offer their financial support, and have workers participating all over the world, helping us raise research dollars. That was genius. Nobody is alone. You're out there with friends, family, co-workers, and, of course, sometimes you rub shoulders with really high-profile celebrities. Here's a colleague of mine that I ran into on the last walk. He and I had always wanted to work together. I pitched the idea of a remake of Dog Day Afternoon. He's thinking about it. I know that Scooby considers his participation with the JDRF to be among his finest work, on screen and off. Are you revved up yet? Are you ready to walk? I should hope so. Because these sneakers were made for walking. These boots are made. They're not only a symbol of our walk, but these little guys raise an amazing amount of money, proving how much you can accomplish $1 at a time. One individual putting one foot in front of the other on one special day. That's you and me and all the rest of us, and that is what is going to cure diabetes. You have no idea how much your participation, just yours alone, means to the children and adults who live with this disease. How important is it? You remember my friend, Holland. She got type 1 diabetes when she was 2. She's 6 now. How much longer will she have to live with this disease and all the threat it poses to her childhood, her growing up, her very life?
Holland has asked one time, well, let's see. I remember one occasion when she said, "Will I have this my entire life?" And we were in the back of a taxi cab, and she just turned to me out of the blue, and it was on the way home from ballet. And she said, "Will I have diabetes my entire life?" And I said, "I hope not, and I don't plan on it. And I'll do everything in my power to see that that doesn't happen." And I guess it was why I became so committed to this organization. And I hope that if I support the research that the JDRF does, that I can turn to her on another occasion when she even better understands what this is all about. That I can say to her, we're that much closer to a cure, or better yet, the doctor just called. Come in for your cure.
We're gonna find a cure.
It's up to us, really. One step at a time. It's up to you. Hi.
Hello. I can't work like this.
Is it for me? Is it my agent?
Hello, I'm walking. I can't talk now. Bye.
No one told me about that button. Those of you students and parents who have joined the school teams, those of you, let me do that again. Being all over the world, raising heavy. Let me do that one again, if I may, in English. I could do that again. One more.